tell them, a line. Hi. Yeah. We're leaving now.
We just had an amazing experience. We went by the bus station where some Venezuelans are, and we had 90 eggs, 90 boiled eggs, and bread and coffee, and I mean, we gave it out in minutes. In minutes, it was gone. It was, the need is just so overwhelming. And, but it was amazing. We got to share Jesus. We had two Bibles to give away, but we need to get more Bibles. Any Colombian friends that watch this video, if you know where we can get some Bibles cheap, or if you can give us some Bibles to give, the need is great. The people are hungry, and they're not just hungry for food. They are hungry to hear about Jesus. They are hungry to hear about that God loves them and cares about them, and that this is just a moment in their life. This is not forever, that God has wonderful plans for them. I talked to an older man, and he almost broke down in tears. He was a lawyer in Venezuela, but he, you know, and he's having a really rough time because he's probably 50. And so, you know, especially for the older people, sometimes this is hard because they've lost everything. You work your life to build and to have security, and then it's gone in a second. But, you know, we talked to him and we prayed with him, and there was some young men who, the one boy needed medicine, so Jorge was able to give them a little bit of money for medicine, but because he fell on a bike.
Somebody
stabbed him. Oh, see, I didn't understand it all.
And there was a girl that I was talking, she got stabbed 17 times, and she lost a lot of blood, and so it was very, very hard, and they need medication, even amoxicillin. She said, please bring amoxicillin, it's an antibiotic, and also if you can have it, she told me, aspirin and things like that.
We can bring that.
Okay, next time we're going to bring that.
Do you want to stop by your parents and say hi since we're so close?
Okay.
Sorry, that was just a little side note. We didn't do this organized. I'm going to tell you what happened. Jorge, I was sleeping because we were up all night. Our neighbors were partying, so too very, very loud. And so Jorge was up and he was reading Luke, and he was reading the part where Jesus says, do unto others as you would have done unto you. And he said, you know, I don't know, we've got to do for the Venezuelans, because if I was in that situation, what would I want somebody to do for me? And so I was thinking, you know, about it as I laid in bed, and I started thinking, because Jorge loves food, I started thinking eggs. They would like eggs. So we went, we got three flats of eggs, and were able to get some bread, and I made coffee, and we took it to them. And it just, I mean, I had no idea, because I really didn't understand exactly the situation that some of the people are living in, that they're living in tents. But it was an amazing experience. It was an experience that was prompted by the Holy Spirit, and we're definitely going to do it again and again and again.
Una preguntita.
And so, anyways, we're at the bus station right now. Jorge's getting getting directions so we can go to his mom and daddy's real quick and say hi. And I think we might go past where we just preached to. And if we do, I'll show it to you. But it was an amazing experience. You know, God, you know, it's sad that sometimes you have to be in those kind of homeless situations to listen and be willing. Oh, we're not going to go past. But anyways, it's sad that sometimes that's what it takes. But, you know, when people are in these situations and they're hungry, they're also open to God, and they're open to hearing about who Jesus is and who they are in Christ, and they really need it. And so this just was an amazing situation, and God's going to open up doors for us to be able to help people in other ways, and we just thank God for that. Do you want to say anything else?
No.
Okay, bye. Bless life.